Alex the lion was the star attraction at the New York Zoo. Alex loved performing for the daily crowds, and he especially enjoyed his nightly steak. But what Alex loved the most were his friends, Melman the giraffe, Gloria the hippo, and his best friend, Marty the zebra. Alex wanted to surprise Marty with a present for his 10th birthday, but Marty wasn't in a festive mood.
You just need to break out of that boring routine,
Alex encouraged him. Suddenly, the zoo clock chimed the hour.
Here come the people, Marty! Oh, I love the people!
Alex cheered. Alex climbed onto an artificial rock and struck heroic poses while fireworks erupted on either side of him. He loved being the king of the zoo. Marty tried out some new dance moves of his own. Later, Marty noticed a spoon emerge from the ground. Four penguins popped up through the hole.
What continent is this?
Skipper, the leader of the penguins, asked.
Manhattan,
Marty replied. The penguins dove back into the hole and were gone as quickly as they had appeared.
You and the tux, wait a minute,
Marty cried. Skipper popped back up and whispered into Marty's ear.
We're going to the wide open spaces of Antarctica, to the wild.
That night, Alex, Melman, and Gloria gathered to celebrate Marty's birthday. Gloria presented him with a birthday cake. Marty thought hard for a moment and then blew out the candle.
Come on, what'd you wish for?
Alex asked.
No siree, I'm telling you, it's bad luck,
Marty replied. The other friends pestered Marty until he finally relented.
I wished I could go to the wild.
After the party, Alex tried to cheer Marty up.
Alex, look at me. I'm 10 years old. My life is half over. And I don't even know if I'm black with white stripes or white with black stripes,
Marty vented. Later that night, Melman peeked his head over Marty's pen and discovered that he was missing.
Gone? What do you mean gone?
Alex panicked. Marty escaped from the zoo through the tunnel the penguins had dug.
We gotta go after him,
Alex said. The three friends took off into New York City to find their friend. Alex, Melman, and Gloria finally found Marty at Grand Central Station. But the joy of their reunion was short-lived. The crowd in the station panicked when they saw the escaped animals. Police quickly surrounded the four friends and shot them with tranquilizer darts. Sometime later, Alex woke up groggily in a dark enclosed space.
I'm in a box!
Oh no! No, no! Not the box! Oh no, they can't transfer me!
Alex cried.
Alex!
Oh, Alex, are you there?
Marty called from nearby. Relieved, the four friends realized they were still together. Meanwhile, in another crate, the penguins plotted their escape. Rico poked his head through an air hole and spat out a paperclip. He picked the lock, freeing the other penguins. They hurried to the bridge. Rico sneaked up on the captain and karate chopped his neck, knocking him out cold. The penguins were now in command of the ship. Back at the animal crates, Alex, Melman, and Gloria started to panic. Alex blamed Marty for their predicament.
You ticked off the people. You bit the hand, Marty. You bit the hand.
Alex and Marty fought through their crates, smashing their bodies against the walls. At the same time, the penguins turned the boat sharply towards Antarctica. The four friends' crates slid across the deck of the ship and careened overboard into the ocean. Alex bobbed up and down on waves until he finally crashed onto a beach. He scoured the beach, looking frantically for his lost friends. Finally, he found Melman struggling in the sand. Then Gloria emerged from the surf. But where was Marty?
Yeah! All right! That's right! Left, left, no, 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 no! Yo left, yo left! Right here is good,
Marty exclaimed while surfing to shore on the backs of two porpoises.
Marty! Marty!
Alex cried as he ran toward his best friend.
Alex!
Marty replied. The two were about to embrace when Alex remembered their argument. They started to back off, but Melman and Gloria ran up behind the pair, falling on them in a huge hug of relief. Before Alex and Marty could renew their argument, they heard music coming from the dense forest surrounding the beach. They thought they must be at the San Diego Zoo, and the music was coming from their new zookeepers. They decided to go into the forest to find them. When the Zoosters emerged at the source of the music, they were shocked to find that it wasn't humans making the noise. It was animals. The local lemurs were having a huge dance party. Marty joined in and danced wildly. He was having a great time.
I don't know where he's at, but he's missing one heck of a party,
Marty remarked about Alex. Suddenly, the music stopped, and the lemurs scattered for shelter. Four large weasel-like creatures called Fusa had crashed the party and surrounded Mort, a little mouse lemur. They were going to turn him into a salad, but Alex burst through the trees just in time. Mort jumped to safety, and the Fusa fled in fear of the powerful lion in their midst. From the safety of nearby bushes, the lemurs watched the strange new animals scare away the Fusa. King Julian, the leader of the lemurs, emerged to welcome the strangers.
We thank you with enormous gratitude for chasing away the Fusa,
Julian gushed to Alex, Marty, Gloria, and Melman. The lemurs told the four friends that they were actually in the wild, not the San Diego Zoo.
Oh, hold up there a second, Fuzz Bucket. You mean like the live in a mud hut, wipe yourself with a leaf? Type wild?
Alex asked nervously.
The wild?
Marty pondered with wonder. Alex panicked and ran back to the beach. His friends followed closely behind. Alex blamed Marty for their current predicament. He drew a line in the sand, separating Marty from the rest of the gang. Alex had a plan. He built a replica of the Statue of Liberty out of sticks and driftwood. That would surely attract a passing ship. But Melman accidentally crashed into the statue with lit torches and burned it to the ground. Meanwhile, King Julian led a meeting of the lemurs in an abandoned airplane nestled in the treetops.
So, my genius plan is this. We will make the New York Giants our friends and keep them close. Then, with Mr. Alex protecting us, we will be safe and never have to worry about the dreaded Fusa ever again,
Julian triumphantly announced. At the beach, Marty built a tiki hut and invited his friends for seaweed on a stick. Alex refused at first, but he missed the others and decided to join them.
You know, I've been kind of a jerk, Marty.
Alex sheepishly told Marty.
But I've been thinking about what you said, and I'm sorry.
Marty immediately forgave his best friend, and the four gazed at the brilliant night stars. Alex awoke to King Julian standing on his chest. Confused, Alex wanted to know what was going on.
While you were asleep, we simply took you to our little corner of heaven. Welcome to Madagascar,
Julian explained. Alex, Marty, Gloria, and Melman turned to look. Before them was an incredible wide-open vista.
It's just like my mural back at the zoo,
Marty marveled. Marty immediately ran into the wonderful new playground and goaded Alex into a game of tag. At first, Alex was reluctant, but he soon found himself sprinting across the plain.
Woo! I feel good. I feel like a king again,
Alex shouted joyfully.
King,
Julian muttered.
Come on, Alex. Why don't you show him some of your act?
Marty prompted. The lemurs were ecstatic to see Alex perform, but King Julian was upset. He didn't like to be upstaged. Alex bounded on stage and whipped the crowd into a frenzy. He roared so loud that he surprised himself. But something strange was happening to Alex. He hadn't eaten in so long that all of the adoring lemurs looked like dancing steaks to him. Suddenly, Alex bit Marty on the butt. The lemurs were disappointed to realize that Alex was turning against them.
I admit it. The plan failed. All is lost. We're all doomed. The forces will come back and gobble us with their mouths because we are all steak,
Julian lamented. Alex was still crazed with hunger and knew he was a danger to his friends.
Oh no. What have I done? It's true. I'm a monster. I gotta get out of here,
Alex decided. Alex left his friends and trekked deep into the wild. He stopped near a cave and built himself a pen similar to his enclosure at the zoo. He didn't want to hurt his friends. Meanwhile, Marty, Gloria, and Melman went back to the beach and were shocked to see the cargo ship approaching. The penguins had come back. Marty ran into the forest to get Alex. The penguins followed close behind.
Well, boys, our monochromatic friend's in danger. Looks like we have a job to do.
Skipper commanded. Marty found Alex at his makeshift enclosure.
Alex! The boat's here! We can go home!
Marty pleaded.
Stay back, please. I'm a monster.
Alex warned.
I ain't leaving without you.
Marty countered. Marty suddenly realized the Fusa had surrounded him. With Alex behind his enclosure, the Fusa moved in.
Help! Help me! Anybody help me!
Marty screamed. The Fusa pounced on Marty. Out of nowhere, Melman swung from a vine and knocked the Fusa off of Marty. Gloria quickly helped her friends up, but they were still surrounded by the pack.
Fusa Hulk!
Skipper tried, to no avail. Alex approached the brawl below. The Fusa made way for the king of the jungle. With teeth snarling, Alex leaned in and whispered to Marty.
Psst, it's showtime. Thanks for not giving up on me, Marty.
Alex then roared at the top of his lungs.
This is my territory! Understand? I never ever want to see you on my turf again!
The Fusa tucked their tails and ran for their lives. The lemurs threw a farewell banquet for Alex, Marty, Gloria, and Melman. The main dish was sushi, and Alex loved it.
The kitty loves the fishy,
Skipper said, delighted. The group boarded the ship and waved goodbye to their new friends. Kowalski asked Skipper if he should tell everyone that the boat was out of gas.
Nah, just smile and wave, boys,
Skipper told the penguins.
Smile and wave.